What impact could Kyrie have on the Nets moving forward?
Well, he can decimate their franchise. Let me be very, very clear with what I'm saying. James Harden can sign an extension. He's got a player option after this season that'll pay him $47 million.
Okay.
He can opt in and then add about 3 years and $161 million to that. Well, what did Malika Andrews report the other day? She talked about how James Harden alluded to, I believe it was Malika Andrews, if I'm wrong about that, my apologies, but I believe it was her, basically reporting that James Harden talked about how he's never tested free agency. He's never actually been a free agent out there. He'd like to see what options are available to him. And here's the thing that we have to pay attention to. This is the same James Harden that turned down a 2-year, $103 million extension from the Houston Rockets. He left money on the table so he could go somewhere that he wanted to go. Mm-hmm. So don't think for 1 second that James Harden likes the nonsense that's going on in Brooklyn. We've been so busy talking about Kevin Durant, we forgot what a superstar James Harden is. Last year was an aberration. He wanted out of Houston. They initially said no. He came into camp out of shape, all right, because he was letting them know he ain't trying to play for them that upcoming season. And as a result, they ultimately moved him. And remember, at the 11th hour, as Jay Williams can attest to, at the 11th hour, Molly, there was noise that the Philadelphia 76ers were about to grab James Harden.
Yeah.
He was about to head to Philadelphia. Brooklyn recognized that, stepped right in at the 11th hour because KD and them was like, what you doing? Get this, brother. And Sean Marks went out there, and he got James Harden. Mm-hmm. We got to remember, this dude is a superstar. He's a multiple-time scoring champion. He's one of the elite offensive players this game has ever seen. And to be quite honest with you, Kevin Durant isn't the only one that deserves better. James Harden deserves better.
He wants a ring.
James Harden deserves better than the nonsense Kyrie Irving is putting this franchise through. So when James Harden speaks up and he says, look, I've never been a free agent before. We all know what Philly's doing. Philly would like Ben Simmons back, okay? But if Ben Simmons wants to be there, the first order of business is for him to get back so he can elevate his trade value and they can move him for equitable compensation. You think Daryl Morey doesn't want James Harden in Philadelphia? You think Doc Rivers wouldn't want James Harden in Philadelphia with Joel Embiid? You're kidding me? Once upon a time, they got a call last year, okay? The Houston Rockets thought, you know, they were about to do a deal that was going to send Ben Simmons to Houston so James Harden could come to Philadelphia. But ultimately, Brooklyn stepped in, and that was where James Harden wanted to go. He's given indications now that might not be the case if all of this nonsense continues. So when Kyrie Irving sits back, clearly thinking about himself and his quote-unquote principled positions, he's compromising the franchise because Kevin Durant is a baller. James Harden is a baller. They don't want all of this other stuff. They want a hoop. And I'm hearing, as of last night, at 11:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, I was on the phone with some people, Jay, and I was told, yo, Kevin Durant, don't think for 1 second that Kevin Durant won't eventually give Brooklyn the okay to move this brother if it continues to be on the path that it is. Don't think he's so married to Kyrie Irving that he's just going to tolerate all of this other stuff. Hell, before they landed in Brooklyn, Kyrie wasn't speaking to anybody, including Kevin Durant. Okay, DeAndre Jordan had to get on the phone and speaking like, what the hell are we doing here? What's up? I thought we were coming to Brooklyn. All right, because Kyrie had went down under. Not literally to Australia. I'm talking about he went down low. He was like, yo, I don't want to talk to anybody. Okay, so we got to pay attention to what's going on. There's some stuff percolating in Brooklyn. And if Kyrie don't get back, all hell might break loose.
You tell me what the trade value for Kyrie is.
Oh, no. It's minimal. I can tell you that for a fact because I was on the phone with at least four GMs over the last 2 days, all saying when the Sixers are concerned about 20 cents on the dollar for Ben Simmons, what do you think Brooklyn is concerned about for Kyrie Irving? Everybody knows he's spectacular, that he's box office, that he is big time when he wants to play. But the question is, does he really want to play? He's so distracted and so focused on other things outside of basketball that right now, league-wide, nobody trusts him. I had one executive that tell me he wouldn't be surprised if Sean Marks could get, if he could, that he'd give Kyrie Irving away for a box of cookies. That's what the hell he said. Literally, I'm quoting, because that's how crazy Kyrie Irving appears at this particular moment in time in terms of being all over the place instead of focused on the game of basketball. So if you're the Brooklyn Nets right now, here you got a situation. KD, and I'm going to say this, and Jay Williams, you're going to lose your mind. Are you sitting down?
I'm glad
you're
sitting
down. Your turtleneck.
I am ready.
You're warm in that 55 weather degrees, all of that right now. I'm about to say something to you. Are you ready for this?
Give it to me.
We got KD. He already agreed to his extension, right?
Mm-hmm.
He already agreed to his extension. But if Kyrie somehow messes all of this up and doesn't get his act together, right, he doesn't end up back in Brooklyn for whatever reason. And James Harden says, enough of this. I ain't going to sign no extension.
I already know where you're going.
I'm a test free agency.
I already know where you're going. You're going back out west.
How about KD? How about
KD? You're going back out west.
You know, I really don't need this. Maybe I should have went to the Garden after all. Maybe I should have went to the Garden after all. I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
This is what Tim Tebow was talking about. It always comes back to you.
I'm just saying.
I thought you were going to say Golden State go back out with Clay and Steph.
I thought he was going to go Golden State.
Hold on.
Because it was about championships, not about Stephen A.
First of all, it's not about championships and it's not about Stephen A, even though that would make me very happy. Kevin Durant has two chips already. We got that. He already did Golden State, okay? When he went to Brooklyn, what did we say about the guard and the brand and what it brings, okay? Again, he signed his extension. He's in Brooklyn. We get all of that, even though they try to front like the Knicks were never a consideration. Listen, Knicks were led to believe Kevin Durant was coming to New York City and then he ended up going to Brooklyn. Don't get me started with that. But in the end, remember, the dominoes potentially can fall. Kyrie Irving, if he doesn't get his act together, and James Harden decides, yo, I'm better off in Philly with Daryl Morey and Doc Rivers and Elton Brand and the crew. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.